Beautiful day in the Piedmont. Temperatures started out cool this morning at 40 degrees, and then this afternoon we got up into the 60s. As you can see by these numbers, we got in the mid 60s, and now we're going to start slowly going down over the next hour. Here's the official numbers for the day. 67 was the high, 38 was the low. That was a very brief period between hours. And as we look outside, skies are looking good all day long from the morning through the afternoon. A few clouds up in the mountains early on, but for all of us, just a few little puffy clouds floating by mainly the south this afternoon, but we will all see clouds increasing tonight. Temperatures are in the 60s to low 70s across the coverage area. Up in the mountains, we've got some 50 degree reports, even colder at the high spots. Winds are blowing today, but not as gusty as they were yesterday. Wind gusts near 25, but we did peak at 31 today compared to 45 yesterday. And up in the mountains, they got the big number. Jefferson hit 63 for a gust today. Down to the south, you see the showers that are out there. That's our weather for tomorrow, but it's not going to look quite like that. It's going to fall apart some before it gets here. This front again is down to our south. It's going to start coming back late tomorrow. Chance for a couple of showers. Our best chance of rain is going to come tomorrow night when this upper level thing I've got spinning here, that upper disturbance behind the surface low, when that comes through tomorrow night, that will bring us our best chance for a shower and maybe even a clap of thunder because of the instability that that upper disturbance will bring with it. And then behind it, high pressure builds back in. Here's a close-up look at tomorrow. Again, you see the shower chance. Nothing that's going to be a washout tomorrow. Just you're going to have to kind of keep an eye on the radar in case you get a shower when you're outside doing something. If you do, it may only last for 5 to 15 minutes. And then tomorrow night, you see this area coming down from the north. That's the best chance we have for tomorrow. Tomorrow night from 10 o'clock until about 2 a.m. north to south across our area. And then Sunday is going to be looking better. And we go a little bit farther out in time. You see Monday, we bring the rain chances back in, and we'll also see some chances as we go into Tuesday. And as I always say, this is a lower resolution product when you go out beyond 2 days. So these are bigger blobs of green. It won't be constant rain in big areas like that, but it does show the overall pattern. And I'm still seeing the evidence of winter weather not too far away on Wednesday, and the model showing it could get down here. Let's look at the European model. This is one that normally does really good that far out. Look what it shows Wednesday. It actually puts snow over us. So we're in a pattern. Again, we got to watch for next week. It's very similar to what we had this past Monday. The only difference is we're getting deeper into the winter, getting closer to start of spring and in spring by then, and normally it wouldn't happen, but doesn't mean it won't happen. 49 degrees, mostly clear skies this evening. 37 degrees overnight, 65 tomorrow, just a few showers. And then as we go on into our extended forecast, you can see we're still mild 60 on Sunday with sunshine, but then we turn colder. And as we look ahead and work our way to the middle of the week, Wednesday, looking for rain, and I put the symbol there. I think we could see a rain-snow mixture, 45 degrees, down to 30 degrees on Wednesday night, 48 degrees Thursday, and 53 degrees on Friday. So welcome to spring, Michael.
What are you doing to us?
It happens. I mean, it reminds me of 1983, and I was actually working in New Bern, where you came from.
Yeah.
And it was March 23rd, 1983. We actually had started spring, and even New Bern had snow.
Well, I was still 4 years away from starting my life.
Oh, my gosh.
Well, still ahead, an officer helped a mother, he says,